Hello guys, today we are going to see the topic about the giardiasis. Giardia lamblia is first discovered by the Leeuwenhoek in 1681 while examining his own stool. Giardia lamblia differs into the 7 genotype from A to G, from which this A and B usually infect the human. It causes both the endemic and then epidemic intestinal disease and causes the diarrhea. In India, mostly genotype B will affect the children. Incubation period for this giardia lamblia is 12 to 20 days. It found in the duodenum and then upper part of the jejunum. Morphologically, it has a two form. One is a trophozoite form and another one is a cystic form. If we talk about the trophozoite form, it having like a motility, it's like a falling leaf motility. In front view, it's like a pear shape. And then it's like a teardrop and it's like a tennis racket shape. In later view, it's like a sickle shape, and in anterior end it's like a rounded one. In posterior end, it's like a pointed end. In dorsally, it's like a convex. In ventrally, it's like a concave. It has a one pair of nuclei and 4 pair of flagella. One is in anterior, which we have the 1 pair, and in posterior end we have the one pair, and in laterally we have the 2 pair of the flagella, and we have a pair of parabasal body through which the parafaxonin will be processed through it, this one. If we talk about the cystic form, it having the oval shape with the presence of the 4 nucleus content with the parafaxonin, and then parabasal is connecting. It is a infective form as well as a diagnostic form. If we talk about the life cycle of Giardia lamblia, the host is only one host. For example, man. Infective form is the mature cyst which is the quadrinucleated cyst. And then mode of transmission is the contaminated food and water with the mature cyst. And then rarely by the homosexual. Excestation happens in the duodenum and the upper part of the jejunum. In each cyst, it releases of the 2 trophozoites within the 30 minutes of the entry. It multiply like this longitudinal divisions of the trophozoites, and it will be adhesions. How the adhesion will be happen? The trophozoites ventral side, we have the bilobed adhesive disc, which consists of the contractile protein and the lecithin, which helpful in the adhesions to the duodenal mucosa and to bind with the sugar molecule receptor in the intestines. In duodenal mucosas, it will erode the intestinal epithelial layer border and leads to malabsorption of the fat, and then vitamin B12 deficiency and then folic acid deficiency. Due to the fat malabsorption, it will like a steatorrhea, fat in the stool, and it will produce like a foul smell, profuse frothy diarrhea. Frothy is like foam, and these trophozoites which release the enterotoxins, which is a cysteine rich protein R136. This is called as the variant surface protein, helps in the persistence of the infections, which leads to the chronic illness. In incestations, it helpful in synthesis of the cystic wall, and the nucleus mature to the 4 nucleus, which form the mature cyst, which will be excreted in the feces, and it will be the surviving environmental and infective form for the man also. If you see here, the man taking the contaminated water consists of the mature cyst and passes in the duodenum. The excestation will be happen, and then the incestation will be happen, and releases of the quadrinucleated cyst, mature cyst in the stool with the presence of steatorrhea. If we talk about the clinical features for this Giardia lamblia, it's mostly the asymptomatic character. For acute giardiasis, we can tell up to the 1 week we call it as acute giardiasis. In acute giardiasis, we have the symptoms like diarrhea, abdominal pain, bloating, bleaching, flatus, vomit. In acute stage, we don't have any of the blood, but we have the presence of fat and the mucus, so we call it as a steatorrhea. It's a smell like a foul smell. And in chronic stage of giardiasis, there is no more absorption will be happen because of erosion of the intestinal layer, epithelial border, brush layer. So there will be a absorptions and which leads to the decreases of the vitamins. So there will be a weight loss, and then there will be growth retardations, and then presence of the blood and mucus in the stools, colitis will be happen. If we talk about the rather than the intestinal infections, we can see the urticaria, anterior uveitis, and the salt and pepper retina changes. If you can see this diagram, you can see the salt and pepper retina changes in the geodelamia, and then it will cause the arthritis, and it will mostly high risk to the immunodeficiency patients and then old age patients. For diagnosis, we can take the 3 stool samples should be taken, and we do the weight mount in iodine mount and then saline mount. In saline mount, we can detect the motility of the trophozoites, and then we can do the duodenal samples by the 2 method. One is the anterior test or the string test, and then another one is the biopsy through the endoscopy, visualizing the duodenum. And then antigen stool test detections, we can detect the through the ELISA, and the immunochromatographic test, which helpful if the if we didn't find anything in through the microscopy, we can do this antigen stool test detections to confirm the presence of Giardia infections, and we can do the antibody detections in the serums, immunofluorescence assay, ELISA for the prevalence of the infections. We can do the culture method for any other research like diamond media method, medium, and then PCR test is mostly highly sensitive, we can easily detect it. In X-ray, we can see the irregular thickening of the small ball folds, and then if you are doing the barium mill, you should take the stool sample before the barium mill itself. Here you can see the wet mount, presence of the cyst, quadrinucleate cyst, and then trophozoites like a pear shaped one, and then if you see the duodenal biopsy, you can see here like a sickle shaped one trophozoites. You can see here lateral view, most of the things is lateral view. Now we talk about the anterior test. It is like a gelatin capsules with the presence of the thread. The one end of the thread, it should be attached to the one side of the cheek, and ask the patients to swallow these capsules after the up to 4 to 6 hours. We should keep this gelatin inside the duodenum itself. It will gelatin capsules, it will dissolve in this content of the gastric and duodenum. Gelatin capsules which attaches of the trophozoites, after 6 hours we should withdraw this thread, and then we should put this into the saline solutions. Trophozoites which releases on sediment in this tube, and these trophozoites which are taken into the microscopic examination, we can detect the presence of the trophozoites infections seen in the giardia lamblia. Treatment for this giardia lamblia is metronidazole. We can take the 250 mg 3 times per day for 5 days. If you are AIDS or hypogammaglobulinemia immunodeficiency patients, we can take the 750 mg 3 times per day for 21 days. Tinidazole is more effective than the metronidazole. Tinidazole is taken for the 2 grams 1 time per day per oral. For pregnancy patients, in case of presence of Giardia lamblia, you can take the paromomyxins. For children, you can take the frazolidine.